have good news and I have bad news. Still no idea what those particle clouds are, but I've managed to fix the transport system. I mean, I fixed another bit of it. Well, it goes to one more station now. Don't complain. Two stations are better than none. Whatever it is, we better be careful. The sheer amount of power required to run this place makes me nervous just to think about it.
Let's not make any assumptions. Yakut, what does the next site look like?
It's a plateau in the mountains. Seems like more of an open area with scattered structures, less enclosed. Couldn't tell much from the drone feed. There's a lot of trees. Looks pretty, though.
Okay. Keep exploring, everyone, but stay alert.
Melville, what did you just upload?
A photo?
I mean, technically, you're right, but...
Is that... I can't tell what that is.
How did you even manage? You're literally taking a picture with your eyes, Melville. I don't even know how to make my eyes go out of focus.
Clearly, you've never listened to one of Herman's speeches.
Some of us are busy doing actual science, not just sightseeing. Thank you.
It's strange that some of these puzzles seem disconnected from the rest. Like it's all unfinished.
Or still evolving.
Looks like Prometheus has given us a way to circumvent some of these puzzles.
So each puzzle has a backdoor. I guess the mythological Prometheus was kind of a trickster, so that tracks.
recharged now. Try accessing the tower, 1K.
There's another one of those monuments.
Thank you.
relevant, but St. Edwald believed that Tetramenos represented the name of God and God's ability to reshape the world.
True, but he was also mad as a hatter.
One man's madness is another man's genius.
Not all things must be balanced. When good is weighed against evil, tip the scale.
I think that was more like a recording. The entity didn't appear. And the system didn't react either.
Stars. Another reflection of the simulation. 1K, what's up? I don't know if there's much to tell. I'm not that interesting. I'm just a member of the scavenging team. Well, senior member. Lead scavenger, I guess. There's not that many of us left, to be honest, and Garrus doesn't get along with the mayor. What else? I have a cat named Bruce. I like old music. I have a collection of antique bottles. I think that's it. He's 5 years old, half goofball, half psychopath. Loves sticking his head into things, chews cables, pees on electrical stuff. Melville banned him from her workshop, but he loves visiting her and peeing on her equipment. I've always loved exploration, seeing new places, that feeling that you're the first person to set foot somewhere after all this time. But you know, it's not even that. It's just seeing new things. The world is full of remarkable sights, and experiencing them changes you. It's not the same as just reading about it. Exactly. Every time I go on another mission, I find something that surprises me, that extends my horizons in ways I couldn't have anticipated. The world is so much bigger than we are. It contains things that we can't even imagine. And if we limit ourselves to our own minds, we'll never grow. I just find it fascinating that these fragile objects have survived for so long. Plus, they're kind of pretty. Oh no, please, no puzzles. I'm so bad at puzzles. I barely got out of the booting process. Elohim thought I might be defective. It might be this. Although there was an expedition to a superconductor storage facility up north, incredibly well preserved, but the logistics were an absolute nightmare. Now that I think about it, there might be some of that in you. Our ancestors built some pretty amazing things. Huge cities, factories, mines, monuments to their history, but nothing quite like this, no.
One case solved all the puzzles in this area, but nothing happened. There was a brief blip in the system, though. Maybe it'll do something later. There has to be some sort of point.
There is a pleasure in arriving on this island. The pleasure of being the first to step foot here in hundreds of years. It is a genuine pleasure, and yet it is also banal. My presence here is of no more significance than that of every other animal. These rocks do not care who walks here, and the millennia between the presence of our ancestors and my brief journey are nothing to them. But even putting it this way is wrong. It is not that the rocks do not care. It is that in some sense, they do not exist. I may stand in awe of the cliffs on the southern coast, but the cliffs cannot look back at me with contempt. They cannot do anything at all.
Everything okay? Me? Well, I was born when New Jerusalem was a lot smaller than it is now, and there was a lot of work to do. I wasn't really interested in technical stuff, engineering and so on, but I was good at keeping things organized. So I got involved with the administration side of things. Making sure the scavenging teams focused on the right materials, keeping track of our energy usage, that sort of thing. I think we've accomplished what the Founder wanted us to. and I'm proud that I helped make that happen. Byron doesn't see it that way, obviously, but I think sometimes he gets so lost in his dreams that he forgets to look at the real world. Of course. My best friend, in fact. And someone I've worked with hundreds of times over the centuries. A good person who cares about the world and the people in it. I just also think he's wrong about everything and extremely annoying. Oh, he does. He absolutely does. I don't know. It's obviously impressive, but I think we should be very careful. We're dealing with powers we don't really understand. I think the only reason to build a lab in so remote a location is because you're trying to hide what you're doing. Or because what you're doing is dangerous. To me, it means accepting a certain amount of humility. Our ancestors thought they could master the world with no regard for any other organisms. They failed to see themselves as part of a greater whole. I think the founder realized where they went wrong and tried to offer us a different path. A path where we have a place in this world, but the world is not ours.
When the first man picked up the first stone, he did not do so to forge a tool. He did so to smite his brother.